just wanted to.
Where's the bloody Air Force?
Found it, 11 o'clock.
Wait!
Spitfires!
Edgar, 11 o'clock. He's lining up to drop a load on that minesweeper.
Practically see it from here.
What?
Home.
Oh, we have a job to do.
Job? This is a pleasure yacht. You're weekend sailors, not the bloody navy. And your age?
Men my age dictate this war. Why should we be allowed to send our children to fight it?
You should be at home.
Well, there won't be any home if we allow a slaughter across the channel.
Bad, Dad. We should be turned back.
They need to send more ships. Every hour the enemy pushes closer.
Dunkirk so far, why can't they just load it Cali?
The enemy had something to say about it.
Come on, come on! Ready on the stern!
She's about to leave.
Long
the all the way.
Can't reload from the beaches?
Better than standing out here with the dive bombs.
It's impossible.
There's no hiding from this, son.
Torpedo!
Wars are not won by evacuations, but there was a victory inside this deliverance which should be noted. Our thankfulness at the escape of our army must not blind us to the fact that what has happened in France and Belgium is a colossal military disaster. We must expect another blow to be struck almost immediately. We shall fight in France, we shall fight on the seas and oceans, we shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. Until, in God's good time, the new world, with all its power and might, steps forth to the rescue and the liberation of the old.